We're speaking today about time. When is it the right time to say that's my bae? When is it the right time to profess love for your bae? A young lady sent a message yesterday. She said she's been seeing a guy for like 8 months. Obviously, rudeness happened. That was her words.
I don't know why it's obvious though that rudeness happened.
For 8 months, she said, oh, come on, it's 8 months, guy. Come on.
It don't have to be obvious.
Come on. Well, she said it. She said, oh, you can check the phone.
I'm abstaining.
See if you find it. Okay, well, she didn't abstain. Right? She said, well, they went out. And she said, imagine this. And some expletives went in there. When introduced, said, so what is our status? Big man reply,
were we just cool?
Yeah. Like, very well bush thing, eh?
Hey! Hey, all here! Status it! Now we just cool, eh?
So here now, here Vanessa now.
What was the face?
Vanessa's here talking to someone for 4 to 8 months now. Right. Know him since 2010. He's helped pay the bills. She does he does help pay the bills, she's helped pay the bills. We go to family stuff together, and the other day she introduced him to his to her mom. Right? Say, mommy, there's my boyfriend. Next day the man gets a long speech and say, he's not your man.
Oh my god, she's a dog.
Wait. No, if you could get introduced to mommy and still come back with that.
Nah, he's sad, man. He's sad. He's
real
sad,
bushman day boy.
But then too, he's have some girls who, you know, they're undecided now. They're going out with somebody for a long period of time. Right? They might have a little falling out or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, you know how things just go. So the bounce of somebody, chats them up for a little 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And I new love.
Yeah, not that it don't work so.
That's newfound love.
It don't work so.
You understand what I'm saying? So we're talking today about what is the time limit?
Oh, this one. Don't claim nothing but insurance.
Oh god. Now she better. That's she or he?
That's a she.
And she said that now. It sounds like a female. Don't claim nothing but insurance.
Nothing but insurance.
Wow. Wow, she went bishops. She went bishops.
Well, look, maybe about 3 to 6 months when the soaking start.
That when you can say it. So, ladies, listen to me. Is it that when that happens, it's considered that we in a relationship?
Apparently.
Once that
apparently
starts, the relationship is official.
Me, I don't understand how you could be in a relationship and you ain't tell me nothing. We didn't have a discussion prior to you telling everybody, I's your man.
Hey.
How we together?
Hey.
You didn't sit down and we didn't have a talk?
What do you mean? You don't need a talk?
What do you mean?
You don't need a talk, Rody.
So what?
No, you don't need a talk.
Man.
There are certain things that two individuals do that does not require a talk.
Right.
It's what we say unspoken rules.
Unspoken rules.
There's unspoken rules.
This is new to me.
No.
Go through.
There's unspoken rules. So there's certain things in life that is like, all right, it's just Bible. Certain things are just Bible. You just know that's how it's going to be. You understand?
You playing woman in the bush.
No. Certain things are just Bible. Bro, it's like this. As that girl was now saying, if every month we created a habit where we go to the supermarket.
Right.
And you have your place, I have mine. But together, we shop. And we separate, meaning you know what I like, so you make sure you have it available at your place.
Right.
I know what you like, I make sure it's available at my place. Right? But we ain't saying nothing. Remember, we going out every day, we think, hold on, let me done. Mornings, midday, afternoons, night, communication is always there.
Right.
You get a hey in the morning or whatever. This is if you're living together.
Day.
Right?
Yeah,
if your relationship is that connected where some nights you stay over, and the nights you staying over, she's like, babe, your thing's in that top drawer.
Right?
You know your thing's in that top drawer. Your little 6-7 underwear, your 2 vests, your 3 pair socks.
7 underwear? Now you in a relationship.
Hold on, my brother.
Boy, it's one pair.
That's what I'm telling you.
That
there's
one
unspoken
over.
Rules. If you have a drawer, you have a pair of sneakers, deodorant, toothbrush, at said residence of the female you are courting, that is your girl.
Even though you ain't saying nothing.
Hey, McGill, listen. Here now, man. You is my girl.
The van say, here now, man.
You is my girl.
The van say, once I buy a drink in the club for you, we on the wee road.
Oh, nah. Not the van. I loading. Nailunas. I'm telling you. And it's vice versa. From the time you, roadie, invite a young lady into your space.
You see?
And start
men
to do...
disagreeing with you here. You say, Jaiga, no unspoken rules. Either you say it or you ain't say
it. No. Don't do me that. It's unspoken.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Them man and them, they're playing tricky. That's the tricky man and them. Them playing tricky. All you know to all yourself, my brother. Like, we don't lie.
Look, Vanessa say close by she too, eh?
You understand?
The man who say she. He's not she, man.
He close. He's a dog. He's a dog. But then too, and that's the next thing. If your man is a dog, accept the fact that your man is a dog. And keep it moving. They're dudes just like that. That's just how they operate. But there is something called an unspoken rule, brother. Fellas just trying to titivate yourself. It have that. Because let me tell you this, right? Let me tell you how man different. With all of that and then all saying it and everything, you know, if she, hear this, if she had things by you, right? Little things, nothing fancy. She have a toothbrush. You understand? She might have two little flat shoes.
Sure, she stay free. The little boxer stay free.
And she might make all that. It's kind of wily. Right? She mightn't. I'm saying it fresh still, Rudy. It fresh, fresh. She have a toothbrush. She have a two flats. Maybe two underwear. A bra, maybe.
Deodorant.
You understand? A deodorant. Yeah. Right? Simple things. Nothing too. She ain't over the top. She
just a soak and leave package you bring up.
Yeah, she have a leaf package. She have a, where's called the weekend bag, the big bag. She have a tote. Right? She have a towel that she knows she uses all the time, that use wash and prepare. That particular towel is hers, right?
So
is that?
Agree with her, yeah.
Hold on, she have that. Men know, right? All that by you, all that by me, right? She have all them things by me. But I play in Tantu now. I know my girl. It's a little friend that has come over.
Yeah.
But if when a Friday evening call come, and you call, and you in girl, right? And you swing by the place, right? And then she little driveway, you know, she key a park up now. Because she have a Rio. Because, you know, she does buy a Rio. She got a money, she buy a Rio. You know, you show with the hatchback one, the new one that come out. Right, she have a Rio. And right in front of the Rio, you see herself, a Sophie pack up.
Big van.
Or a big van. You see a Ford. A Ranger. Or a
Navara. A Navara.
Yeah, pack up. And you call. Right?
And you walk to come.
Hold on.
You travel to come?
You ain't travel, you drive.
Oh, you drive too, right?
Because, you know, it's Friday, you just swing by your thing, but you ain't talked to for the day now because you had a small falling out.
Yeah.
Right? So when you swing by now, you call and no answer. But the place in darkness, then bam, you look so. You see a light come on and a light come off. But you call and I get no answer. Right? But you remember, you playing Tanto. That ain't not your business thing. You playing Tanto.
Yeah.
What you thought?
Yeah, but
you can't. Whoa! You can't toot. No, for what? You forget you're not telling me it's an unspoken rule. We're tooting for what you're tooting for.
At the end of the day, win something.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, you're reaching
what
something.
I thought, you see, you're getting me wrong. What I talking about is you going at your free will and introduce me as your boyfriend. That is what I talking
of
about.
Course, but
yes, we in a relationship.
Yo,
but
y'all remember? Y'all remember that is girls, buddy. You are there. No. Let me, the guys who are out there listening to me, if you know you don't want to be placed in that situation, brother, to be introduced the wrong way, there's certain events you find a way to get
now,
out
so
of.
Wait now. So if it
if
goes
she
the other
going,
way around.
Hold on. If she going, if the cousin getting married and the cousin having an engagement party, and you know she father, grandmother, thing, cousin, aunt, everybody going, you had a belly pain that whole day. You cannot go because you know when she carry you there. Hi, mommy. This is Rodel. This is my boyfriend, Rodel. You know you going and get that. If you know that, I know
why
who you want to be.
Introduce me as a friend.
No, brother. No girl will introduce no man as friend. That is the biggest disrespect,
you know,
in the world.
If it was the other way around, we would have to have that discussion with her.
Of course.
You understand?
Because but that, again, it is no
I
them
can't
girls.
Just, I can't just go introducing you as my woman and we have a discussion.
There's no them girls. There's no them girls have a way about them. You know the girls you can introduce us. Yeah,
that's
no
true.
And you know the girls you had to go. Yeah, that's my friend. Because you know them better. And the better ones, there's no, because here why? Here why there's no, you have a better girl, right? You're going on with all this talking every day and cooling on. But you see the actual time to see her.
Oh, the phone blowing up.
You see the actual time. You see the actual time to see her. You and she tight and all this talk every day. Yeah, it's not the better ones, right? You and her tight. You just talk all the time. Laugh, kick, go to lunch. But you see when work time over. If you know you don't have a consistent Monday night or senior Tuesday night as you, then you know she better. She better. Trust what I'm telling you. Well, boy.
I still say I need a little verbal agreement, huh?
Verbal.
Especially when I say you're introducing me to people.
Let me see what we're doing here.
Putting for nothing that is not mine. If we in talk and say, hey,
this is it. This is what we're doing. Mm-hmm. This is not what we're doing. Yeah, I cannot toot.
I hear you, my brother.
Vice versa. Straight down the center.
I hear you, my brother.
You know why I go toot? I go toot because we're in a relationship. No, I go toot because, oh God, at least tell me the man in a van come in now. Don't make me show up. And if the van just pack up outside of your bald face, or what?
Daddy, we never say no Maria. Wherever it is. Ranger, wherever it is.
Daddy, you and the Navarra man and them.
We have a relationship, so you can't tell me the man coming over. Eh? I had to
come there in my cube. Pull up the seat set individual there now and light turning off and turn them back on there.
Hey, hold on.
Nah, man.
I agree with Roddy to a point. If you don't have that conversation, I don't see we on the reroad. This is Nicola from New York. You must have that conversation to state whether they're in a relationship or not, even if they're doing the nasty. Mm-hmm. So what, you know, grown folks, whatever, you have an agreement or things happen. But if you don't have that conversation to say, you know, I like you, I think I should start dating you, or we in a relationship, you know, we just... two consenting adults, if you want to put it down.
Alright. But some of these voice notes and them, listen, ladies.
Long boy.
Ladies, some of these voice notes long like rice and road, boy. What are they doing, man?
Morning, Jaiga, Roddy. How you know your relationship, or you're actually in a relationship? Well, of course, somebody has to make the first gesture. In my situation, my husband, my now husband, made the first gesture. He had his own apartment because he was finishing up his master's at UE, and we met at a mutual lineman spot. And every time I would, you know, come over and lime and this kind of thing, he would say, spend the night now. And you know, of course, I would tell it's a hard ticket, right? But he was real sexy, I ain't gonna lie.
All right now, Miguel, all right. You're married now, everything nice, all right.
The first gesture was, come on, girl, spend the night.
I'm sure she went on to say think something along the lines of, look at key.
All right.
If a man gives you the key.
Yeah.
And when you go out with him and you introduce your girlfriend and you watch him up and down,
you
deserve.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
if I give you the key to my place and I carry out along with my friend and him, and I, hey, Rudy, me my girlfriend, and she turn and go, hi, I'm his friend.
Nah.
Right then and then I walk my thing and it's back and I'm like,
give him my keys. I'm
looking for a black one come out in me. I'm telling you, I'm not going through that. You understand?
Hey, Jaiga, Roddy, let me tell you something. Tell me, she had to tell me it official. Because here, what? Assumption is the mother of all poop.
Man,
don't
want
assume.
To do it. Men not assuming.
Don't assume.
All them men belly weak, boy.
Yeah, nah. Morning, Roddy, morning, Raw. Do some Grenada here. Look, we all know the situation. Here, what's going on? If you're not talking about it, we know is there's a certain word I can't use on the radio, but something friends.
Right.
But once it come into the, we start talking, we know, well, bam, we're in a relationship.
All right, buddy.
Right, so
I am starting to be convinced that the man and them are this dog.
Oh, boy.
This dog.
So because,
man,
I want a verbal contract stating that, hey, this is official.
All they're saying is all well and fine, but give me a new knocking and it's real good, yeah, it's mine.
I like it. The man say, Miguel, listen. I like what's going on with me and you.
You
is mine. Here now, man. Die with the back and I'll listen.